Live via satellite from Hollywood, it's Rockline, the show where you interview the hottest stars in rock and roll. Hello again, I'm Bob Coburn. Rockline is brought to you in part by Budweiser. For all you do, this bud's for you. Tonight is a double bill Rockline featuring Stevie Ray Vaughan and Richard Marx. So get your questions ready and call us toll-free at 1-800-344-ROCK. That's 1-800-344-7625. One number toll-free from anywhere in North America. Also, stay tuned tonight for details on how you could win a trip to see Jackson Browne in concert in New York City as our 8th anniversary celebration continues on Rockline. Stevie Ray Vaughan has helped make the blues more popular than ever before, and a new Stevie Ray album is always cause for celebration. Tonight you're in for a real treat as you get to hear portions of Stevie's still unreleased album, In Step, for the first time anywhere. As Rockline welcomes Stevie Ray Vaughan, nice to see you again.
Good to see you again, man.
Great to have you here. First thing I want to ask, how long has this album been finished? When did you say, this is it, we're done?
About 2.5-3 weeks ago.
2.5-3 weeks ago. And now how long before it's actually released to the public?
It should be in the stores by June the 13th.
So June the 13th. So we're talking a month and a half, something like that in between.
Uh-huh.
Now what do you do in between while you're waiting for the record to come out? Do you rehearse for tour? Do you make a video? What do you do?
We are already on tour. We were already on tour, and we've just made a video yesterday for the first single, and just having fun with it already.
And the first single is going to be Crossfire?
That's right.
I think we're going to listen to that right now. We're not going to play songs in their entirety because this album will not be available, as Stevie Ray said, for a little while. But we are going to give you a good, solid taste of two or three songs this evening so you can hear what Stevie Ray's been up to in the studio here.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's been doing good work, folks. Crossfire, Stevie Ray Vaughan. As I told you, we can't play all of each song, but there's a pretty good taste of Crossfire. Had to wait for the guitar solo, at least there.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Stevie Ray Vaughan, and also joining us is drummer for Double Trouble, Chris Layton. Chris, nice to have you here, too.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Now, that last song, Stevie Ray, you wrote a lot of the material on this album, but you weren't involved in that last one. But, Chris, you were. You wrote that with Reese Winans and some other people.
Reese Winans, the keyboard player, and Tommy Shannon, the bassist, and Bill Carter and Ruth Ellsworth, who are songwriting team in Austin, Texas.
Now you must be happy. I mean, it's the first single and the video shot for that, and you got to be thrilled, huh?
Yeah, I am.
That's great. And it sounded pretty good. Let's take a call now. We have Johnny on the line in Chicago listening to the Loop FM 98. Johnny, good evening. Welcome to the Rock Line.
Hi, how y'all doing?
Good.
Yeah. Hey, Stevie, I'm one of your biggest fans, and also, how do you, when you play the blues on stage, how much of it is, improvised, and how much is actually like planned out, or how much do you know?
Oh, I try to know what key I'm in, and other than that, I just play what comes to mind, man.
So it's not all lick for lick, note for note. You just you go with the feeling.
There's a good idea of what each song is what complements each song. But as a rule, the solos and the intros and everything, it's just when we found the best way to start the song. And I found a few things that really feel good about, there's your basic plan out, but other than that, it's all just off the top of my head.
There you go, Johnny. Thanks for being on tonight. We're going to head now to Clarksburg, West Virginia, and speak with Janie. She's listening to V93 FM. Hi there.
Hi. Yeah, I was wondering, how do you approach your songwriting process, and what's the style of your next album going to be like?
Well, each song is different for me, and I believe it's that way for everyone. Sometimes I have bits and pieces of the lyrics. Sometimes I have an idea just for a riff or how the verse may want to go. And I just take each one as they come. Sometimes it's real quick. Sometimes it takes years for a particular song. That's how it works for me. Chris?
Well, just kind of start in on something. An idea starts somewhere, and usually the next person, somebody else, will just jump in on something, and it just pieces start falling together until you kind of get a basic core idea, and then just kind of develop it from there till you figure you've got a song.
Yeah. Yeah. And as far as the tone of this next album,
we've still kept our roots. I don't know how to lose them if I wanted to. There is new songs, so there is new directions. But it's us. It's solid double trouble.
You'll get to hear some tonight, Janie, so you stay tuned. Now, you have written, I mentioned a moment ago, you had co-written some songs with Dee Bramall. Is that Doyle Bramall?
That's
who's
Doyle
now,
Bramall. Uh-huh.
Now with the Fabulous Thunderbirds.
No, that's his father.
That's his father who's...
The person who's with the Thunderbirds is the son, the guitar player, and he's mean. And he's upside down and backwards and the whole bit. So if you hadn't figured out how he does that one.
So there's two of them out there. Double trouble. Look out.
That's right. Doyle Bramhall, who wrote the songs with me on this album, is the father. I've known him since I was about 12 years old. We've played in bands together starting, I guess, about 72. It's different forms of a band. And we've enjoyed writing together ever since. This time I had quite a few songs started and was looking for someone to collaborate on, because I like to do that. And I wanted to really try it on this record. And uh-huh. we ended up getting together for a week or two and came up with six or seven songs. And four of those made the album.
Some good ones, too. Janie, thank you for calling. We have to take a time out. We'll have more from Stevie Ray Vaughan and Chris Layton in just a moment. And Richard Marks will join us a little later on. And in a few moments, I'll have the details on the Rockline Jackson Browne World in Motion contest. When we return on the Global Satellite Network, call us toll-free from anywhere in North America at 1-800-344-ROCK. It's Rockline.
Hi, this is Greg Allman wishing Rockline a very happy birthday. Keep on rocking.
Thank you very much, Greg. I have some concert dates for Stevie Ray Vaughan and Double Trouble I'm going to pass on to you right now. The 18th of May, you'll find them in Phoenix. San Diego, the 20th, the 21st, in Santa Clara, California, then Santa Rosa, the 22nd. Sacramento, the 23rd, followed by a date in Eureka on the 25th. Salem, Oregon, the 26th of May, and then the 27th in George, Washington. Wait a minute, is that, that can't be.
It's real.
George,
that's what I said.
In the state of Washington. That's just unbelievable. And then on the 29th in El Paso, Texas, which is KLAQ's 4th International Balloon Festival, Memorial Day. And, of course, that's one of our Rockline affiliates. I'll try and mention more in a few minutes. There are a bunch. But right now we're going to take a call from Hudson, Colorado. It's Shelley, a listener of 106.7 KAZY in Denver. Good evening, Shelley.
Hi. Hi, Stevie.
How you doing?
Oh, I'm doing great. Hey, Stevie, as you may know, many successful young musicians today are falling victim to the musician's lifestyle. What advice would you give them and their band members to let them know that there is hope before everything falls apart?
Well, the first thing that can be done is maybe some people can learn from other people's mistakes. I, for one, have already made a lot of these mistakes, and I'm having to come back into life, so to speak. Just try to learn from other people's mistakes and don't try to prove that you're the exception. You know, it helps.
There you go. Well stated. You've learned a little bit from a couple of your mistakes, too, haven't you?
Oh, yes.
Good call. Shelley, is that everything on your mind tonight?
Yes, it is.
Thank you for being on with us. We appreciate it. We're headed now to Canada, to Hamilton. We're going to talk with Russ. He's listening to CKOC. Hi, Russ.
How you doing?
Good.
That's good.
How about you?
I'm not bad, thanks. I got a couple questions. Are you guys coming to Hamilton?
Well, we will as soon as we can.
Okay, and when you just got off tour, when are you planning to go back on tour into, say, a bar or a big arena?
Well, we're doing some of both types of things. We're doing small halls and arenas. The tour is actually as it is scheduled out for about a year, possibly longer. So I'm sure we'll get around to just about every size venue there is.
There you go, Russ. I don't have Hamilton scheduled in front of me right here. I do have Ottawa, Toronto, Montreal, and Quebec City, all in the month of June on the 14th, 16th, 17th, and 18th. Colin James from Canada will be the opening act for a couple of those shows at least.
Yeah.
And he can play.
That's
and
a gas,
definitely
too.
Definitely play. That Russ, thanks for being on. We're going to talk now to Jared in Austin, Texas. KLBJ FM 94 is our affiliate there. Jared, you're on the Rockline.
Hi, Bob. Hello, SRV.
Hello.
Austin's in step and waiting for you to come home. I've got two questions for you tonight. You've been quoted as saying that Jeff Healey will revolutionize the guitar world. Can you expand briefly on this quote?
I'm not sure I said that. No, he's a great player, and I really like what he does. I like how he approaches it. You should stay out of the way when he starts swinging his guitar, though.
Yeah, he gets to moving, doesn't he? What was the other question, Jared?
Hey, is there any truth to the rumor that you'll be featured at the Miller Lite Party for 2 million Texans on September 2nd, 1989?
Well, we'll see. I can't answer that question yet, Kat.
There you go, Jared. Thanks for being on tonight. We're going to play a taste of another song off the forthcoming album, In Step. Now, this album is dedicated to the late John Hammond, isn't it?
That's right.
Now, for those who don't know, John Hammond was a man who very much appreciated music. He signed a lot of the biggest acts in music from, I believe, Billie Holiday on down the line.
That's right.
And his son's a pretty good blues picker himself, John Hammond Jr.
Yeah.
Right now, we're going to play something from the forthcoming album, In Step, Tightrope by Stevie Ray Vaughan and Double Trouble on Rockline. Tightrope, Stevie Ray Vaughan, and Double Trouble on Rockline. We're with Stevie Ray and also Chris Layton from the band. Will you come back at some point and let us play songs all the way through? And you know, once you know, I mean, it's kind of frustrating.
I was kind of hoping you'd ask that.
It's a nice treat, but it's kind of a two-edged sword here. We're going to take a call now from Ottawa. It's Gary on the line, a listener of Shea 106. Hi there, Gary.
Hi, Stevie.
Yeah.
Good to hear you're doing well.
Thanks.
Listen, I've got your first album, Texas Flood, in my lap, and I've been wondering, who is the man... The older man with the suit jacket on the back of this jacket, he just doesn't fit in with your group, and I've always wondered who he was.
Oh, he fits in, all right. That is Mr. John Hammond.
That's John Hammond.
That's who we recorded that album for, as well as this one.
There you go. Good call, Gary. And yeah, he found out. And yeah, he does fit in.
That's great. Yeah.
Thanks for the call. We're going to talk now to Kevin in Chicago. The Loop FM 98 is our station there. And Kevin, you're on the show.
Hey, Chris and Stevie, how you doing?
Good.
Good. It's good to hear. You know, you guys have become my favorite band over a couple of years.
All right.
And I thank you for it.
Thank you.
The reason is, you know, I value people's opinions, but a lot of artists nowadays are putting political aspects into songs, and you guys have stayed away from that. I'm wondering why you have and if you're going to still do that.
Well, it's more like we just talk about the things that mean a whole lot to us, and right now I'm not feeling too political.
Yeah,
that's about all it is.
But you wouldn't rule it out in the possibility of something really moved you.
If something was important to me, I would talk about it if I possibly could.
There you are, Kevin. Keep on enjoying the music, okay? We're going to go from Kevin to Karen. Karen's in Fort Lauderdale, 97 GTR in Miami is our station, and we welcome her to the Rockline. Hi, Karen.
Hi.
Hello.
I'd like to ask Stevie, do you use the same guitars in concert that you use when you're recording?
Yeah, I have several that I choose from, and it really just depends on which one feels and sounds the best for the particular song. Live, I usually play, I go back to my first girlfriend, my first wife, number one, whatever you want to call it. I've been in love with that guitar since I saw it, and things ain't changed that much since then.
Yeah, there you go. Now, how many do you have at this point, do you think, just as a guess?
Probably 30, 35.
Yeah. And how many do you really play, like actively play?
About five.
About five, yeah. Mm-hmm. That's a good call, Karen. We thank you for it. We're going to play a taste of something else. This is a great song. This is off the forthcoming album, In Step. It's a real treat for everybody tonight to be able to hear a taste of an album that's not out yet. This song is called Wall of Denial, Stevie Ray Vaughan and Double Trouble on Rockline. Good taste of Wall of Denial for you by Stevie Ray Vaughan and Double Trouble from the forthcoming In Step album. Sounds like some personal growth reflected in that.
Thank you.
Yeah, you betcha. A couple more concert dates quickly, all in the month of June, the 20th, Saratoga Springs, New York, Burlington, Vermont on the 21st, then Old Orchard Beach, Maine on the 23rd, Bristol, Connecticut the 24th, Mansfield, Mass the 25th, followed by Dayton, Poughkeepsie on the 27th, and then Pittsburgh on the 29th of June. Stevie Ray Vaughan and Double Trouble coming your way. Check with your Rockline affiliate to find when they're going to be in your town. Call from New York now. It's David, a listener of 92.3 K-Rock. Hi, David.
Hi, how you doing? How you
good.
Doing, Stevie?
Hello.
Yeah, I saw you a couple years ago at the pier in New York City, and Steve Winwood showed up to do the encore with you, and I was wondering if you and Steve had maybe laid down something on vinyl or plan to work together in the future.
Not yet, but we sure would. I'll go along with it.
Yeah.
Call him and ask him next time he's on the show.
Anytime, anywhere.
Let me know what he says.
We'll get him to commit next time he's on. All right. There you go, David. Thanks. Let's talk now to Tracy in Houston. He is listening to 101 KLOL. Hi, Tracy.
Howdy from Texas.
Hey.
Hey.
I was playing Texas Flood in rush hour traffic in the rain today. It got me through.
Great.
We've worn out all four records. We're looking forward to In Step.
All right.
Do you have any albums prior to Texas Flood in 1983? And if so, what label are they on?
Well, there was one done when I was in high school that's really not worth mentioning. There's a 45 that I did with the Cobras on Viper Records that was just a regional thing out of Austin. Other than that, there's the Let's Dance album that I worked on with David Bowie.
Yeah.
That's the only things prior to or before Texas Flood. That's the only things.
But this one's only a couple of weeks away there, Tracy, so you don't have to wait too much longer.
You won't have to wait long. Stick with us.
Thanks for calling. We appreciate it. We're going to head now to Canada, to Edmonton, and talk with David, a listener of K97. Hi, David.
Hi, how you doing?
Good.
In a recent interview, I heard you say that you have given up drugs and booze. And I was wondering, how does that affect your live show, and how did that affect the making of the new album, In Step?
Well, it's been about 2.5 years so far that I've been able to be sober. And, you know, the drugs and the alcohol only makes a person think that things are going better. They're really going worse and quickly downhill. So all I can tell you is that it's a lot better nowadays. That had to do with, that's what In Step's about, man, is I'm glad to be walking. You know,
taking it one day at a time, huh?
That's right.
That's the way to do it. There you go, David. Thank you for calling. We appreciate it. Thank you, gentlemen, for stopping by. Chris Layton, Stevie Ray Vaughan, thanks for a great album. I wish we could play more. You got to come back. You promise you will?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You promise? All right. We're going to write it in stone out in the hallway here.
Okay. I'll help you.
All right.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Richard Marks will join us in just a few minutes. You can give him a call toll-free at 1-800-344-ROCK, and I'll also be giving you all the details on how you could be one of three Rockline listeners to see Jackson, Brad, and the Big Apple when the Rockline 8th anniversary celebration continues on the Global Satellite Network.